Hey y'all, my name's Priscilla and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing a book review of Sleeping Giants by Sylvain Neuvel. And this is a book that I recently read, kind of sped through, and really liked. So I thought that I'd share that with you today because the third book in this trilogy, this is the first in the trilogy, will be released this year. So it's good timing for you to jump on it if you're interested. And this is a debut science fiction novel from this author that follows our main character, Rose, who as a child is riding her bike and is pretty much swallowed up by the earth. And she's found in a metallic huge hand surrounded by all these turquoise lights, glowing lights and inscriptions, which may not be human. And then we get a jump 17 years in the future, and now Dr. Franklin, which is Rose, is now a PhD physicist, has been called to lead this team to discover what is this artifact all about, and maybe there's some other pieces involved, and how they're scattered across the world, underground and underwater, and how they have to discover them, and what their purpose is, and what that means for humanity. Spoiler alert, it's a huge robot. And this hand is just one piece in the robot, and there's this arms race to discover all the pieces. Our main cast of characters includes other main characters. We have Kara Resnick, who is a US military pilot. We have her co-pilot, Ryan, and we have a linguist, a Canadian linguist named Vincent Couture. We also have this mysterious unnamed narrator that is connected to all these characters, and that is the foundation of all the whole entire story. So this novel begs the question of, are we alone in this world? Are there more advanced creatures in this world? What is the purpose of this artifact and all the other pieces that go along with this artifact? What does that mean for humanity? What does that mean in a political stance with other countries if the US is the one that discovers all these pieces and discovers how it functions? And at what cost are we willing to discover the purpose of this huge robot? This is a book that received some substantial hype when it first came out. It was compared to World War Z and to The Martian, which I can't really attest to because I haven't read either of those novels. But from what I can tell, those movies are very different. So I think that that's just a marketing ploy to get some interest and some buzz about this novel. However, more recently, I have heard that this novel is actually more likened to the YA Illuminae. While the premise of this novel isn't unique, we see man and machine combine together to fight some unknown evil many times in sci-fi. I think in this novel, what is unique is the writing style. And this writing style is dossier style with mostly interviews, but we also have other recordings and transcripts and news articles and other journal entries from all of our main characters. So I can understand why many people don't really like this, because the text in the ebook and in the hardcover are just pretty much conversations. It's a lot of dialogue and it's a lot of this unknown narrator asking questions from our other cast of characters. I think that this can easily wear on the reader as the book progresses, and it's also a bit of a learning curve in acclimating to this style of writing. And the first half of the book does lay a lot of groundwork and it kind of puts a lot of the pieces together. So in that way, I would not recommend this text at all. I listened to this on audio and my experience was a lot different and a lot more pleasing than I expected from some of the mixed reviews that I had heard. I was pleasantly surprised to hear a full cast of characters and a production value that I think really deepens the characters and the character development and the overall storytelling. This catapulted my otherwise what I think would have been a 2-star rating if I had read the physical form to a 4-star rating with this audio production for sheer entertainment value alone. It's really gripping and thrilling. So now for the positives and the good things about this novel. So this premise isn't unique. You know, we see like big machines and robots and humans with Power Rangers, and more recently with the movie Pacific Rim, which once I made that Pacific Rim connection, I was hooked on this book. I think that if you like Pacific Rim or any other of those robot man machine kind of stories, then this story is definitely for you. This novel has some moments of action and suspense that really kept me wanting to know more the more that I learned. It was thrilling. The more you discover along with these characters, the more questions you have, and the more it kind of pushes you to the edge of your seat. You're on this quest for truth with these characters, and the way that the writing style is, we don't know what's happening sometimes until things have happened. And I think that this adds to this suspense element of this story. So we mostly get the perspective of this main narrator, this sinister, manipulative narrator. Don't know much about him. And when I say sinister, like, I'm thinking like pinky in the brain, I'm gonna take over the world, I want all the power kind of sinister. Speaking of the narrator and the characters, while I do think that the text in its original physical form kind of disconnects you from the characters in the way the writing style is, I think that the audio version makes up for in its production and its full cast of characters. I'm really impressed at how these voice actors have really given life to this story. And even with this writing style, I felt like I really got to know these characters, and I felt like it really dragged some sort of emotion out of me for each of these characters, whether I hated them or I grew to respect them, or I grew to be disgusted by them. Like, it really drew something out of me for each of them. Okay, so now for the bad. There is a completely unnecessary love triangle that is used as a plot device in this. I don't think you need to create love triangles to kind of create this tension. So that's always disappointing. If you hate the whole telling versus showing kind of writing style, this may not be for you. Because of the interview style, we don't ever actually see something happening as it's happening. We hear about it later on, and it's very much probed from this narrator. And he kind of already knows what's happening, but he wants to like know how you feel or how you saw or what you heard. And it's very much a one-sided, biased interpretation of the events that have already happened. For instance, there's this major event where there's this sort of arms race and resulting geopolitical strife between a couple of the nations in retrieving all these pieces and finding all these pieces around the world. That's really interesting, but we only really hear one side of it from one of these interviews with one of the characters. So I really enjoy like the elements of political ramifications and these philosophical humanity kind of elements that are being questioned. But I mean, you're really being told what happened and how to feel about it from these one person accounts, one person experiences. And at the end of this novel, there is a very obvious cliffhanger for a second book in a trilogy. So overall, I would have liked more of a story arc in one complete fulfilled book. However, this was a very compelling and propulsive thrill ride of a science fiction novel. And overall, I'm really happy with it, and I'm really excited to get to book two. Sleeping Giants was fantastic. It's intriguing from the opening, and it's downright scary at times because I think that these science fiction novels about robots taking over or aliens taking over is very realistic, but that's probably just me. So I recommend this for science fiction fans that like very quick and easy reads on audio, of course, and maybe for people that don't mind unreliable narrators. That's all I have for this non-spoiler review. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I'll catch you in the next one. Bye!